Okay.
Thou art
good.
My son.
Come. I'm with you. I'm with you.
Good. Good. Let's go to Psalms 22 and 16.
Yep, that's the one.
This Come. Prophecy was fulfilled.
Come. Book of Psalms, Elohim, chapter 22, verse 16, reads, "For dogs have compassed me, the assembly of the wicked have enclosed me, they pierce my hands and my feet."
Mm. Who's that talking about, JD? That's prophecy of what was going to happen to a HaMashiach. Oh. And he got pierced on the cross.
Like I said, I'm not saying that he didn't mean it, but many of them were.
Who is it talking about then, JD?
Messiah.
Tell me that I should know. But HaMashiach, he fulfilled this prophecy.
Oh.
Did Matthew. He not?
The second coming, the second coming, you're saying, right?
No. This was already fulfilled by him. This was already, he was crucified by the Romans. Was he not, JD?
Yes, he was, along with many, many others. Yes, he was.
Okay. Okay, but there's no others that this is referring to.
So the resurrection is not going to happen.
Other ones are not mentioned in the scriptures. Huh? Was that, JD?
The resurrection is happening in the second coming? The resurrection?
Yep.
Okay. So it says one should not presume and one should not presume that the Messianic King must work miracles and wonders, bring about the new phenomenon in the world, resurrect from the dead, or perform other similar deeds. This is definitely not true, right? So it says, proof can be brought that Rabbi Akiva, one of the greatest sages of the Mishnah, was one of the supporters of King Bar Koziba, and would describe him as the Messianic King. He and all the sages of the generation considered him to be Messianic King until he was killed because of his sins. Once he was killed, then he was realized that he was not the Mashiach. Sage did not ask him for any signs or wonders. That's the issue that we're having, because the death is the part that we're the issues that we're having. Because he was, you know, but then the second coming, I guess you'd say.
But the prophecy said he was supposed to be slain, so I'm confused on why his death is a problem.
Tell me about where he's supposed to be slain, because he just said piercing the hands and the feet, right? That's what is that the same one you're referring to? The piercing part?
Yashami, get Isaiah 53 and 7.
Oh. The book of Yeshaya, Isaiah, chapter 53 and verse 7. He was oppressed and he was afflicted, yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shearers is dumb, so he opened not his mouth.
Jump down to verse 9.
Verse 9, and he made his grave with the wicked and with the rich in his death, because he had done no violence, neither was any deceit in his mouth.
Who are we talking about there?
Mashiach.
In you said Isaiah? It was Isaiah?
Gone.
Mm-hmm. Isaiah was talking about the prophecy of okay, I have to read that again.
You could read verse 10 too.
Verse 10. Yet it pleased Yahuwah to bruise him. He hath put him to grief. When thou shalt make his soul an offering for sin, he shall see his seed. He shall prolong his days, and the pleasure of Yahuwah shall prosper in his hand.
Yes, if we follow the rules, right? Follow the Bible. Tazadak, I sent you an email. I try to do a collection of all the references that I could find with regards to not just the Mashiach, but also Yeshua in the five books in the Tanakh. I mean, okay, I can believe that the scripture. Sorry.
Let's read some more. I think we read the Boreum.
But the question I still have, is if Yeshua is Melech HaMashiach, or the Mashiach, let's just say the Messiah, do we look at him as the Son of God, or do we look at him as the way to God, or do we look at him as just another man of God, like us? Or is there something that is a different level that we are using him as a crutch to get to God, or is it help or support?
Yeah, that right there. That right there.
Support that right there.
We must walk with him in order to reach the Father.
That right there. Yeah.
And Yeshua learns about that. Sorry, go ahead.
No, let me bring out some more precepts. I'm going to put this out here so I could, I need to put this vibration out here. Let me put some precepts out here, then you could decide. What's the last precept I gave you guys, man? Because this word needs to go forth, man.
I believe it was Tehillim 22.
Psalms 22 and 17?
Come on.
No, we didn't read that one, did we?
Yeah, we did. I'll read it again, though. The book of Psalms, Tehillim, chapter 22, verse 16. For dogs have compassed me.
Yeah, we read 16. I remember that.
Come.
Go ahead, read all the way down to 18. Go ahead. And someone grabbed Proverbs 8 and 23. We're going to read 8 and 23 all the way down to 31. Go ahead.
The assembly of the wicked have enclosed me. They pierce my hands and my feet.
Okay, stop. Hold on. JD, this is talking about HaMashiach. They pierced his hand and feet. There's no other man in the scriptures that they're referring to this as, aside the two Gentiles that was on the cross adjacent to him. So this is definitely talking about HaMashiach. It's not talking about David. It's not talking about Solomon. It's not talking about any other man of Israel except for HaMashiach, Yahushua. Go ahead, read.
Verse 17, I may tell all my bones, they look and stare upon me.
Now watch this. This prophecy, I read all of this earlier tonight. You need to go back and listen to this video because I was talking about when they parted his garment. Read verse 18, watch this.
Come, they part my garments among them and cast lots upon my vesture.
Did we not read this earlier?
Come.
And what they referred to as the basura? Prophecy fulfilled. See, it was all prophetic that this was going to happen to him. So if you can't receive this, then, anyone that's in the audience that can't receive this, you need to pray for understanding for Yahuwah Elohim, man. From there, let's go to Proverbs 8 and 23.
God.
I got to tell the truth, man.
Book of Proverbs 8, verse 23. I was set up from everlasting. From the beginning, forever, the earth was.
Okay, stop. What is he talking about right here? He's talking about when you read in Bereshit, and it says, in the beginning was the word. That's in Yochanan, but when you go back, it says, let us create man.
Come on.
He's saying he was back there with the Father. Now, this can't be talking about David, because David wasn't there with the Father. It's not talking about Solomon. He wasn't with the Father. But whoever this is it's talking about someone that came out of the seed line of David. So who else could this be talking about other than HaMashiach?
God, verse 24.
Well, hold on. Pause. Let's go to Genesis so he can see what I'm talking about. Because I want everybody to be able to look this up, go back. Let's go to Bereshit. Someone, you hold that, Yashabin. Someone go to Bereshit 1 and 26. Watch this.
Call in the book of Genesis 1 and 26. And Yahuwah said, let us make man in our image.
Stop. Let who?
Let us.
You said that didn't say, let me make man.
Let us make man in our image.